What's up, guys? It is Friday afternoon. I think it is 4 o'clock. It's 3:52. Gonna head out. We're on our lease property tonight. It's the first time ever hunting it. I'm actually kind of nervous about hunting it tonight. Don't really know what to expect with the property or anything. We have one picture of one good buck. That's it. But he's a good buck. As you can see behind me, that was a cornfield. It's not a cornfield anymore. They just picked it this week. So maybe those deer are going to be out there feeding. Last night we had a cold front move through. And from my experience, deer move pretty good after a cold front. So I'm excited, a little nervous, like I said. It's like 68 degrees, so it's not too terrible. So I'm gonna get all dressed up here, get the bow ready, get all the camera gear ready, head out. We're gonna be hunting a ladder stand tonight, just overlooking this cornfield. The ladder stand has been on the property. This is our first year having this lease. And the cornfield or the ladder stand was here, so I'm gonna take advantage of having that here. Maybe somebody, whoever's it was, knew what they were doing and put it there. I don't know. I'll have to wait and see. I did want to ask you guys. I've been thinking about doing a series on the channel, kind of like hunting stories, where I share some of my past hunting stories, and maybe even if you guys were interested in sending me videos of you guys telling everybody, you know, like your most memorable hunt. I don't know. I thought it would be cool. Everybody's got a story. Everyone should get to share it. If you're interested in that, please leave a comment down below. And if there's enough interest, maybe we'll give it a try. I'm at least going to make some videos of my most memorable hunts and whatnot. Everybody likes a good hunting story, so. Alright, I'm going to finish getting all this gear ready. I'll see you guys in the tree. We're up in the tree. I already jumped one deer coming in here. It looked like it was just a young fawn. I assume so. It wasn't a mature doe or anything. This is what we're working with tonight. Behind me, where the deer are going to come from. Oh, there is that deer. That deer's out in the field working its way back already. That's funny. Deer should come from behind me to go out to the field to feed. And then this. That's what we're working with tonight. That deer's right over there walking through the field. That's crazy that it came back that quick.
So since I last talked to you guys, I've had a deer come running across the field in front of me, and then turn around and run right back, which I can't explain it. The deer had to have ran right by my truck, because my truck's parked over here. And I also have at least 3 doe out in the field. I'd say 100 to 150 yards away. They're just out there feeding on whatever corn is left on the field, I guess. A lot of deer movement tonight. It's nice. I wish I had my big camera so I could actually, like, film everything and show you guys, but yeah, I guess it is what it is.
It was a really eventful night as far as doe are concerned. And I mean, I saw, I'm going to say close to 15 deer tonight. Obviously, I didn't get to show you guys just about anything because I was stuck using my cell phone and the iPhone is not made to film hunting, at least at a distance. Close up, sure. We're going to go out tomorrow morning. So I'll see you guys in the morning. I gotta get down. I gotta get down.
get into the last hour of light, I'm hoping something